My name is Tessa. I'm 25 years old, and I just... I'm really shy to say it. I don't know why, but I come in the name of the Lord. He's telling me to say that. I come in the name of the Lord, and everything I am is because of who He is. Everything I am is because of Him. And that's totally true. And I was delivered 3 years ago, as of yesterday. I was delivered and brought to God. I always knew of God, you know, like that kind of distant relationship kind of thing where you know He exists, but you don't ever talk to Him personally, or you don't ever listen to His voice personally, and you don't seek after Him at all. That's what kind of relationship I had with God before. And that one day on December 3rd, 2013, he picked me up. I was coming off of drugs, and I don't know why, but he told me I was worthy to be loved, and I got baptized that very day in a bathtub, and my life wasn't the same after that, because I met God, I met the Lord, I met Jesus, and my life was never the same. And it was so hard for the first year, because I was so stubborn. I didn't want to listen to any of the advice any of my elders gave me, even my mom would give me advice, and I didn't want to listen. I still had the kind of attitude, like I knew what I was doing, even though I had met God. And finally, when I came to Teen Challenge, that's when things started to change. God started to soften my heart, and He started to open me up to open up my eyes to everything around me, because there's a spiritual realm going around us, and there's always a spiritual battle going on around. And one day I prayed to Him. I asked Him, God, I want to see the spiritual realm. You know, I want to be able to see it, because I think it would make it easier for me to follow You and to listen to You. And that was a pretty crazy prayer to pray, because now He is opening up my spiritual eyes to see. And it's not in the way that I thought it would be. I thought He would open my eyes and I would see like little figures or something. It's not like that. He opened my eyes, and so now I can see behind actions of what I do, and I can see my, like, how my heart is, the motives of my heart, and I can see the spiritual realm that way, and I can see how Satan keeps trying to lure me away from God again. And so God's opened my eyes, and like that's really strong. And so that's keeping me on that narrow path. Is after that prayer, I'm now able to clearly see that what God wants me to do and what He doesn't want me to do and why He doesn't want me to do it. And He's just blessed me so much. Like, I don't deserve the kind of relationship that He's given to me, and that so much speaks for His character, His grace, because it's not because of anything that I did. I know, because I messed up my life so bad. I was in addiction. I was living on the street, and my family was really irritated with me because I was just using them. And in Teen Challenge, I have purpose again. God's using Teen Challenge to show me that I have purpose in life. I have His love to share with others. I have His words to share with others. And I can be an encouragement to others through His Spirit. And I feel so blessed, and I have so much hope inside, because when I hear of people having hope and receiving the Holy Spirit's hope, when I speak, I get so excited, because I'm like, I'm a part of it. I'm part of Your kingdom, God. And that's my only desire now, is to be a part of God's kingdom. It's my greatest dream. And I came through a lot, and I'm just so glad to be standing here. I want to share a verse. It's like a really special verse to me. It's one of the, Jeremiah is like one of the chapters, or a couple of the chapters in there are really, really special to me, because they were the first verses I heard when I had my spiritual ears open. And it's Jeremiah 33:3. It's one of my favorite verses. And I have loved You with an unfailing love, and I have drawn You. No, wait, I have loved You with an everlasting love, and I have drawn You with unfailing kindness. And it's a verse that I got when I first met God. And, Jeremiah just speaks to me so much. And thank you.
My name is Greg. I'm Manny, brother from Winnipeg. I have to say, I'm in a little bit of a strange mood, but I want to share a verse first, because Hebrews 12, verse 1 goes through my head a lot, which is, therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw out everything that hinders, and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. The reason why this verse is in my head, actually, is because of not that, but whoever chose this picture did a little bit of a number on me. So thank you, whoever that was. This is a castle in Germany, in the Bavarian Mountains in the south. And I've been there. That one. He knows it. I don't remember what it's called, I just know it's in the mountains. And to give you an idea, I had a really good life. I went to church, I was baptized at 19. Later on in life, I started to drink, and I really started to enjoy drinking. And it was about 6 years of drinking that really caused a lot of grief for my family. I almost lost my daughter because of it. And I almost lost my life because of it. And being in the hospital, when you're dying, you sort of come to the end. And I said to God, take my life or give it back. And he decided to give it back to me. So really, the more I think about it, that race that was marked for me now, is I see it a lot clearer. And I know what I have to do, because if he gave me my life, I have to give him mine again. And through the process, what happened this week, and the reason why I mentioned this castle, I'll get to that in a second, is on Wednesday, I had to have another gastroscopy. If you don't know what that is, it's not fun. But when you drink a lot, your liver fails, and then you get these things in your esophagus called varices. They're veins that might burst and all that kind of stuff. But they have to shove this tube down your throat and tie those off. So that happened on Wednesday. And I love to sing. Singing is it's one of the most important things for me. And when you keep having this is now the sixth time I've had to have this procedure. And because they keep finding these things in me. And every time I go in, I'm really afraid that I won't be able to worship God by singing. So that's really hard for me. And what I've been ultimately and thoroughly blessed with is the fact that I still can. Now, the reason I mention this castle is because in this castle, the person that created it was crazy, but he loved music. And in this castle is a music hall that is acoustically perfect. You can whisper and hear everything. So we went on this tour, and at the end of the tour, the English tour, as they go down the stairs, I stayed behind, and I sang by myself, and I was able to worship God in that very castle. I sang the entire O Holy Night, because it was just before Christmas, and I haven't had many experiences like that, and whoever chose that picture brought this memory back for me, and I thank God all the time now for that, because I love to worship, I love to sing, and to hear you guys singing that song today brought me back to my childhood, to my church, to singing, and to hear you sing how marvelous, how wonderful, it was just fantastic, so you guys have really blessed me. And I'm thankful for that. So, a little bit different testimony for me, but I'm really happy. So, thank you.
Do you want to know what reality is? Reality is having to step into adulthood when you're 11 years old, having to care for your emotionally unstable dad and two little brothers. You learn that love is conditional and doing your best is never good enough. Reality is having someone take advantage of you sexually, but because you're so hungry for love, you become addicted to chasing after love and sexual relationship with men you don't even know. Reality is being unfaithful to your husband, lying, cheating, and manipulating him so you can continue drinking and seeing other men. How do I know that's reality? Because that was me. Reality is choosing alcohol over the love of your family, leaving home and living on the streets because though you feel so hungry for love, you don't feel worthy to receive it. Reality is ending up in the hospital by ambulance. Traumatizing your mom over and over again because you want to quit using drugs but you just don't have the strength to do it on your own. And reality is allowing a stranger to decide your worth. Exchanging your body for the price of a drug because you're believing lies that you're worthless and that nobody cares anyway. How do I know that's reality? Because that was me. Reality is dying to have the love and affection from your father, but never able to receive it, so you go searching for a love online. Reality is turning your back on God and becoming so angry at him because you believe you allowed to be sexually abused by your grandfather. Reality is suffering from depression and anxiety so badly, you become addicted to trying to kill yourself because you believed your life wasn't worth living for. How do I know that's reality? Because that was me.
Though we have different realities, we all share the same truth. And truth is, the love that we know from this world always comes with conditions, but the love of God is unconditional. And ever since I had my first revelation of who He is, I haven't wanted to pursue anything else. Truth is, God is changing me from the inside out, and He's showing me what true beauty is, which never come from outward appearance. And truth is, I don't need my husband to meet my need and expectations anymore, because he can't. I'm learning that the only one that can meet the desires of my heart is my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Is that God's word says that for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him will not perish, but they will have eternal life. And I'm choosing to put my trust in God and his promises. And the truth is that I did quit using drugs and alcohol, and it was true. I couldn't do it on my own. I needed the help of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and it's only by His stripes that I am healed and delivered from that life of drug addiction. And the truth is that on June 2015, when I came to Teen Challenge, I believed many lies about my life. But God always knew the thoughts and the plans that He had for me. They were thoughts and plans for good, not for evil, to give me a future and hope. Because of that, I'm choosing to change my life forever.
Truth is, God is the Father of the fatherless. And every day He has shown me the true meaning of love, and His love is much greater than any man could offer. Truth is, God has given me the freedom from the bondage of sexual abuse, and through Christ alone, I was given the strength to forgive my grandfather. Truth is, I almost did succeed in taking my own life. But the next morning, I had a message from Teen Challenge saying that there was a bed available. And in that moment, I knew the Lord had heard my voice. He had heard my cry for mercy because He turned His ear to me. And I will call on Him as long as I live.
And Jesus said, "You shall know the truth, and the truth will set you free."
Thank you. praise you, Lord. And our hope this morning is that, you know, whatever brought you here this morning, whatever brought you to church this morning, if there's a distraction in your life and God is just speaking to you, let's just put those distractions aside this morning. Let's just focus on Jesus. We're not here to tell you a bunch of glorious stories this morning or to get your feet tapping with music that doesn't mean anything. We're here to point people to Jesus. We have no other purpose here this morning. And so this morning, as we just get ready for some testimonies, we get ready for some worship, let's just put ourselves out in front of Him this morning. And God, we just worship You this morning. We give You the glory. We thank You for Your Son. We thank You for that precious blood. That precious blood that was shed for us, so undeserving. We thank You that although we are unworthy, You have made us worthy by the blood of the Lamb. And we cannot say thank You enough this morning. We just say how marvelous and how wonderful You are. Thank You, Jesus. Just sing that again. Just sing that with me again. How marvelous, how marvelous, how wonderful. Amen. Amen. You may be seated.